G'day and welcome back to Buildsum. And in this video, we've actually been through now and we've set up all our formulas and we've actually come up with a total for our sheet. And I'm just going to bold that answer. I like the main answer to be bold and italicized just so it stands out. And when I did that, I realized I made a mistake. I actually realized that I had 110 mil for the thickness of our slab when the plan quite clearly says 150. So this is a really good mistake to make because I can actually show you how the sheet works now. So the idea is that because we've set this all up to calculate itself, if I just change that to 150, you'll see that that answer there changed. It actually has taken that down to here, all right, and it's calculated our new total. So you know, a silly mistake that would take ages to recalculate in on a calculator. It's very quick to fix in a sheet or an Excel type program. Okay, so now that that's been fixed, what we want to do next is we actually just want to finish off with the total up here. So in a estimating sheet, the total or the answer, it doesn't go at the end of your description or end of your calcs. It goes back up next to your description. So the unit is what you're going to, basically what you're going to buy or purchase the material in. So concrete is meters cubed. Okay, it's priced in meters cubed. I'm just going to justify that and I can vertically align it as well. Put it up there and I should do that for all of these. So center and vertically aligned. And so the quantity, when we do a quantity in an estimating sheet, we don't worry about point anything. We just want to round it up to the next whole number. So there's lots of little functions in this function tab. So there's a few ones I use quite often, but there are hundreds of functions that you can do, okay? And you can look through there and you can do, you know, Google Help and find out what they all do. But if you know what some of them do, you can pick them up pretty quick. So I know in here that there's a roundup function. So if I just go equals and start typing roundup, it'll come up, okay? So you can actually put in some rules and a bit later in some other videos we might look at that. But all I want to do in this case is just simply round up to the next whole number. So I'm just going to select the roundup function and then I'm going to scroll down and select the cell where I want my answer to come from. So that's it there. That tells me straight away that that's going to round that up to 17, which is what I want. So I'm just going to hit enter on that. Go back up and my quantity there is 17. Okay, it's that cell down there, round it up. In here, I'm going to put in my rate. So I'm going to say $300 a cubic meter for the concrete, and we want to put that in dollar signs. So if you come over here, these are our formats. You can see you got the old pound sign there and percentages and that sort of thing. If you go on the more formats area, once you've used it once or twice, ones that you use commonly will come up here. All right, so I could just pick Australian dollar, but you guys probably won't have it there. You'll have to go down to this more formats, go to more currencies and search through find Australian dollar. It's sitting there at the top for me and apply that. So that's come up as $300 with the right money symbol on it. And then we just need to get a total. So our total for this particular job is going to be the 17 times the 300. So select where we want the answer, hit the equal sign, 17 star for times the 300 equals, and we get a sum, a total of $5,100 for this particular job. Okay, so in the next video, we'll just have a look at completing our estimating sheet, the next item, and totaling up those items, and then we can have a look at creating a summary sheet. G'day, I'm back. Just to let you know that if you like this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel or you can follow me on Facebook so you don't miss out on more great videos.